dedication to Bob Zosky and the Athletic Center, it seems all too appropriate. It seems all too appropriate that the building that was almost washed away before it began in the April flood and was almost washed away when it was almost completed in the October deluge should be dedicated on the coldest and windiest day of the year. Thanks for joining us. It's my pleasure to start the program by introducing Seth Rezaian, who's going to do the national anthem. I'd ask you all to rise for that and stay standing so that Reverend Dr. Richard Knight of the First Parish Church of York can offer the dedication prayer. Most of us will remember the Field of Dreams. Today we are dedicating our building of dreams. Build it and we will walk across campus from the lower school to take our first physical education classes, learning how to move and taking our first steps as athletes. We will join the soccer and basketball clubs and start to understand the idea of teams. Build it, and we will move into the middle school intramurals and learn about teamsmanship and sportsmanship. We will compete for the first time at an interscholastic level. Build it, and we will travel throughout Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts, representing the upper school in the Eastern Independent League and the New England Prep School Athletic Association. Build it. We will enjoy being athletes. We will train. We will sweat. We will aim. We will grow as athletes, as team members, as friends. Our coaches will teach us, mentor us, and occasionally even yell at us. Being Berwickians, we know that we will almost always be outnumbered. And we know we must work harder and be better teammates. But we also know the special pride of real, not virtually, achieving. Yes, I'm talking about our basketball teams with the start beginning to building their basketball tradition group. Build this building and we will build that basketball tradition. Build it and we will practice and practice and practice. We will even practice during fall hurricanes and spring mud seasons. Build it and we will dance the like fantastic, melding art and dance and sport, showing that this thing we call learning is not the business. Build this building, and we will build dreams. The Kozlowski Athletic Center now is new construction. The floor is a month old. The curtain, a week old. The walls are covered with new paint. The locker rooms are clean, at least mostly clean. The wooden dance floor and basketball floors have not faced their first sanding, the carpets are unstained. I dare you to travel ahead and into the future for 25 years. Well into the next millennium. Floors sanded again and again and refinished. Walls repainted, machinery repaired, replaced. Lights broken and repaired and replaced. Floors carpeted and retiled. And not even a faint memory of today's new building smell. But think what will have taken the place of that news. A building of dreams and a building of memories. Think of what these walls will witness in the next 25 years. Blue and white weekends to come, the pep rallies, the gut-wrenching defeats, and the awe-inspiring victories. The heroics of individuals and the heroics of teams. Think of the lifetime friendships that will be built in this building. Think of the simple hard work of individuals and teams. Think of the hopes and wishes and cheers that will echo through this building of dreams in the years to come. Yes, build this building and we will build dreams, we will build memories, we will build traditions. But there was a hitch. We had to build the building. The building, before it could be built, had to go through a process of gestation. I'm not going to burden you with all of that retelling, although I'd love to talk about that water line one last time. I will also not take you back to the early debates over hockey, tennis, and basketball. Although I do want to thank those who first insisted that we do better by our athletes. I will remind all of you that less than 18 months ago, no money had been raised and no plans had been drawn. This building of dreams was simply that. It was a dream. It took form in the mind's eye of a courageous board of trustees, and it took a great many hearts and ready hands to make it a reality. I ask you to take a couple minutes now to help me acknowledge these people. First came the ever-grateful task of fundraising. Our committee included Terry Meyer, Bill Cormier, Jim Dean, Bob DeVore, Bruce Sticker, Mike Dolan, Deirdre Jordan, Susan Roberge, Susie Hanna, Kip Libby, Dan Raposa, Harry Rebels, Ruth Rio, Winthrop Smith, Dolores White, and Frank Willett. And it was led by the Academy's Czarina of Institutional Development, Joan Jordan. The committee made films, posted copies, threatened, made phone calls, begged a little, begged a lot, and reached the goal within 2 months. Paralleling the efforts of the fundraising group were those of the building committee, made up of Bruce Sticker, Mike Dolan, Rob Dutton, Russell Jefferson, Kip Libby, Dina Newman, Ray Ramsey, Dan Cook, Susan Roper, John Spencer, Ned Thompson, and led by Terry Gagnon. There's one important omission here that I'll get to in a minute. The saga of our 2- and 3- and 4-hour Tuesday morning meetings deserves to be told, but it also is beyond this occasion. I started to think of it as a team putting in long hours of practice to make a successful season. I will remember us as the Tuesday team, and I have a remembrance for each of the team members, thanking them for those long morning hours, if they will come forward. I also want them to stand up and stay here a minute and don what they're going to be doing so I can have you see them in their full regalia. So could those people come forward now? Stand up here. Building committee, I need those folks. Thank you. tell you that there are a whole flight of other people who need to be acknowledged in the subcontractors. Dick and I went through that and we tried to figure out how we might do it. And I at least want to mention a few of these people. Dick and I agreed on this group, but it is a little arbitrary. The point of this is there were a lot of wonderful people involved. The roofing was done by Custom Metal Roofs, the electric by Northwind Electric, the masonry by Meyer Masonry. A lot of the engineering was done by Civil Consulting and Tom Harmon. Mick Johnson and Jordan did the heating system, and we're grateful to them today. And Mick Construction did a lot of the site work and did a lot of the work on our campus, transforming those roads and drives and parking. I'd like to thank all of those people. So there you have it, our building of dreams. But we all know point and counterpoint. We know the story's not complete. Others gave even more that we might have this athletic center. On October 7th, we were reminded in a sudden terrible moment of the cost and sacrifices that all too often lie behind triumphs like the athletic center. Nearing the completion of the work on the roofing of this very room, Ryan Rodriguez fell to his death. None of us at the Academy knew Ryan, yet mysteriously he is now a part of us. His gift to us is this building and a reminder that life is precious. Will you please join me in a moment of silence for Ryan? I would like to ask you to join me in welcoming Ryan's mother and father who have joined us today. Stalwart this facility. From the beginning to the end, Dennis Kozlowski insisted our building be a place of quality, a building of dreams, in fact. It would have been so easy on several occasions simply to give up. But whenever we reached those points, Dennis was there to insist on the best of and the best for the Academy. Last year, the Academy inaugurated the Founders Medal in recognition of Skip Kendall's leadership of the Capitol campaign. As we start our third century, we are ever aware that Berwick Academy needs new founders to join Parson Thompson, William Hayes Fogg, Sarah Byrne Jewett, and all of the others who sacrificed so much so that the Academy could be a place of excellence. It is my great pleasure to award the second Founders Medal to Dennis Kozlowski. Doing so, I would like to read this inscription. Whereas he has served as an overseer and trustee of the Academy, whereas he is president of the Board of Trustees, whereas he has provided vital support for the campaign for Berwick's third century, whereas he led the effort to build the Kozlowski Athletic Center, and whereas, because of those efforts, today's and tomorrow's students will have the opportunity to be their best, Berwick Academy thanks and recognizes on January 17, 1997. L. Dennis Kozlowski, with the Berwick Academy Founders Medal.
Don't. On behalf of the Berklee Academy student body, not just the hundreds that are in this room right now, but the thousands that will be drawn to this academy, to the hills up, by this athletic center, I'd like to extend our sincerest gratitude and thanks to Mr. Dennis Kozlowski. This is a card signed by the entire student body, upper, middle, and lower schools, and everybody's little message that they'd like to send him on to. So thanks again, Mr. Kozlowski, for your generous donation.
Thank you.
give it up for them.
Thank you.
hold your ears, they step. Cat. Will you guys hold your ears and they step? Here we go, tell me.
Set up on a cushion of rubber with grommets, so that the floor has a lot of bounce to it. It is different from the floor in the gym, and it's quite a bit different from the floor that was in the house.
The floor was a big concern. Yeah, it's been a real noise, I need to say. That's one of the toughest tasks to get the person through.
If we hold the floor, think it's great. I really like the huge space and the speakers, nice speakers all over the room. I think it's vast improvement from the last one. The large size room is great. I think the windows are wonderful. It's very nice. This is great. The floor feels good. The bars are nice.
I don't know if it's just because of the size, but the amount of light on this great entrance, obviously there's a lot more window space.
I think it's really neat. You can just like see the outside from the inside. And it's really cool about under here and do it from the other side.
First thing I noticed, I get all messed up with the mirrors looking in and out and wondering, you know, who's real and what it is. So I think the mirrors were the first thing.
I'd say that, lighting, it's very picturesque. Great mirrors.
Lots of mirrors. I have very art and athletics as we have with this facility. I think it opens a lot of communications anymore. I think the program. Our students are asked to do so much. The athletes are the artists, are the actors, are whoever else. And dance being in the athletic building is going to be a benefit because it's going to provide an exposure for our dance program, which didn't exist in the previous location over in the art center. People who came into the art center were the creatives, the musicians and the artists and the dancers and theater. Yeah, individuals whose love of arts is pretty outgoing and up front. And over here, you're not only going to see those students who are interested in the arts, but you're going to have the exposure of them, which will be a benefit. Athletes and coaches seeing what's happening in the dance department and looking at the value of it in terms of physical activity and movement as well as an appreciation. So there's going to be an additional exposure here, which did not exist in the original facility.
We're starting to see them, which is great because they're really athletes and they have a lot of stress on their feet and legs, and I think it's important that they be attended to as well as the other athletes.
We just completed arts residency with Arthur Hall, who is internationally. His first reaction walking into the building when he saw the Lloyd's Movement Education Center. First of all, he couldn't believe that. He travels all over the country and he has not seen a studio dedicated to movement education anywhere in his travels. And his reaction to me was, I thought I had died and gone to heaven. And then the second comment was, if an institution, an educational institution, knows something like this, there's hope in the world yet.
Sixth grade dude coming on now, fourth grade, and they're going to be doing Stop! Yeah. Jump rope! Thank you. I know this, but I was quite a jump rope myself. I moved on to the pogo ball, lost my touch, I guess. Got greedy or something. Now we're going on to the line dancing fifth and sixth graders. I got that one right. Thank you. Seventh and eighth grade free throws. 63-36. Good match. There's more shooting by some other people. So now we're moving on to the toilet paper races. Now the point of this is that groups from each grade, 9 to 12, and including the faculty, will stand in a little group. One person will have to wrap the toilet paper around the group, and if it breaks, they have to rewrap and start where they left off. It's a bunch of fun! Now the groups come up. Groups come up.
Thank you. JV boys are playing at 5:30 today against Bancroft right here, and 2:30 on Saturday against Holderness. The JV girls are playing at 5:00 against Wayne Fleet here today. If we have JV boys hockey, Captain Jeff Allen, Coach Mr. Clapp, Jeff Paul.
Championship game for New England, and we battled through a 4-overtime tie and were awarded a co-championship of New England. Being the gracious team that we are, we let the other team take the trophy, and it wasn't until recently that our trophy showed up, and this is the official presentation of the New England championship. Thank you.
Spirit, of course, begins with individuals. And what we have to do right now is to recognize three individuals who have led this school through the week in school spirit. For the lower school, would Brittany Reed please come forward?
Thank you.
Fletcher and for Nate Hall as MCs. They were wonderful. Sue Maddock organized the pep rally. Greg Bowen and Kip Levy organized the dedication games. Thank them. Finally, for all of you who have been around here very long, you know that whenever there's some music involved and there's a strange idea that somehow works, Nate Anston's there. And a special thanks to him for his contribution.